Blackbox. Most of people don't need it. Until they do. Apparently, some of the experienced guys don't know how to record Blackbox, and some of the advanced guys might not know all of the nuances. So in this video, probably two videos, I will try to cover what is Blackbox, how to record it, how to record it in the most efficient way for your purposes, what recording frequency you want to choose, why you don't want to go too high, why you don't want to go too low, and what is too low. And finally, where you can share your Blackbox file to get some help from experienced people. This video, part 1, is mostly for beginners. So feel free to check the content menu, jump to call with expert, put like, subscribe, and just move on.
Like and subscribe now!
But first things first, let me call to the biggest Blackbox expert ever.
That's kind of interesting. Oh, this should be good. Hey, what's up, Lamone?
Please tell us everything about Blackbox.
All right, hold on a second. You got that on your phone? All right, cool. Yeah, so that's a box. And, you know, it's a black box because it's kind of black inside. So, yeah, it's just that simple.
So Blackbox is a little chip on your flight controller. Well, it could be also SD card or a separate device that you have to solder to your flight controller. But the purpose of this device, of the Blackbox, is to record a bunch of data and measurements while your drone flies in the air. And it records it at a very high frequency, hundreds of times per second, for every second of your stupid flight. Poor Blackbox. What is this data? What are all of these measurements? Well, there is a lot. First of all, it's your drone orientation in the air, all of the angles. Then all of the angle velocity for all the axes. Then all of your motor commands. Then all of your commands from your sticks that the flight controller receives. Then all of your PID values for all of the axes. And there is actually more, way more than that. Now the question, why? Well, if your drone flies without problems and you're satisfied with the performance, then you don't need Blackbox. But if you have some problems with your drone, or maybe you want to fly it a little bit better, or maybe you want to check your feelings if they're real, or maybe you want to help Betaflight developers to test the new features they're working on, well, welcome to the troubleshooting world. You have to have Blackbox. Well, in some cases, you don't have to have it, but if you do, it's still way easier than if you don't. So if you want to buy a flight controller, I highly recommend you to double check that it has Blackbox chip. And the size of this Blackbox chip doesn't really matter, because all of them are capable of recording at least a couple of minutes. And, well, that's all we need. The situation is a little bit different for Tiny Whoops. It's really hard to find all-in-one Tiny Whoop board with Blackbox. But Tiny Whoops are just Tiny Whoops. But if you still need to record Blackbox from the flight controller that doesn't have it, then there is an option like OpenLager, and there is a nice video from Mr. UAV Tech about that, how to use it, what is that. I will leave a link to that video in the description. I never really understood the flight controllers, which have the dedicated slot for SD card for Blackbox recordings. It feels like it's too much. Who needs 4 GB? Of black boxes? Like, people usually don't record black box until they really need to, and then after troubleshooting you probably need to turn it off anyways. Alright, maybe something like Gyroflow application, when you need to have all the black box recordings from the whole day, maybe it makes sense sometimes. But if you happen to have a flight controller with SD card for black box, first you need to format SD card into FAT32 or FAT16. You need to make sure your SD card is fast enough, and also you don't need a really big SD card, because the maximum size is 4 GB anyway, so you can have only 4 GB total of your Blackbox recordings on this SD card. So now we got a flight controller, let's record some Blackbox. Well, first of all, if you're using external Blackboxing device, then you need to open ports tab, find the port you're using for Blackbox, and set Blackbox logging, and then click save and reboot. In my case, this flight controller has a Blackbox chip built in, so I just open Blackbox tab and double check that here it is selected onboard flash. If you're using SD card, then you can select here SD card or serial port is for external Blackbox devices. Next one, you have to choose Blackbox logging rate, and this is very important. This is basically how many times per second you want your Blackbox to record the new measurements. For example, 50 Hz means just 500 times per second. And for example, 2 kHz means 2000 times per second. The general advice is if you have F7 flight controller or H7, then recording at 2 kHz is pretty safe. And if you have F4 flight controller, then recording at 1 kHz is safe. And if you don't know what kind of flight controller you have, it's right here in the left corner of configurator. You see, in my case, it's STM32F7X2. So I can record at 2 kHz. Brrrr. Actually, this is not true. Well, not true anymore. Starting from Betaflight 4.3, it is safe to say that you are good to record Blackbox at 2 kHz, even on F4 processors, even on F411, even without crazy overclocking. This is true if you are not running crazy amount of dynamic notches, if you are not running more than 4 motors with bidirectional D-shot, and if you're not overloading your OSD with a lot of useless elements. And even if you do all this ridiculous stuff, it is probably still alright to record at 2K on F4 processors.
But we didn't test all these crazy cases, so if you do, let us know how it goes.
F7 and H7 processors are capable of recording even at 4 kHz, but there is really no point in recording in faster than 2 kHz, it's just a bigger file size. You don't even really need 2 kHz, because 2 kHz is very fast and you need that like only if you need to fine-tune your filters on the drone with a high-frequency noise. Mr. Steve, the Betaflight developer, he is guilty for making Blackbox in Betaflight 4.3 way more efficient. And if you want to know more about that, I already have a video for you about why Betaflight 4.3 took that long to release. And we discussed scheduler, we discussed DMA and other stuff, so check that out if you want to be a real nerd. And we're gonna talk about Blackbox recording rates and about a couple of tricks for Blackbox recording in the next video in part 2 about Blackbox, but this video is for beginners, so let's move on. If you happen to have a BMI gyro, then you might notice that these are actually the fractions of your PID loop. So on BMI gyro you will have 3200, 1600, 800, 400, and 200. And so on F7 processor, you can record at 3200 Hz. And then on F4 processor, I wouldn't recommend you go above 1600. We will talk about logging rate in details a little bit later in this video, but now let's move on to Blackbox debug mode. This dropdown allows you to select the extra data you want to be recorded. And there are a lot of data types here, but for general purposes, you only need to be aware of a couple of them. The first one is none, no extra data. And this is totally fine for general troubleshooting and PID tuning. The next one is gyroscaled. It allows you to record the raw gyro readings before they got filtered by the Betaflight magic. Gyroscaled is your best friend if you want to check your frame resonances, if you want to see the motor noise, if you want to troubleshoot your filters or you want to fine-tune them, then yep, use gyroscaled. Why it is gyroscaled and not gyro raw? Well, if you select gyro raw, then the gyro readings will be recorded in the weird units. And gyroscaled is recording the measurements in the degrees per second, which is just, you know, easier. Another debug mod I like to use sometimes is D-Shot RPM telemetry. It records the actual motor RPM that flight controller reads from the ESC, so how fast each one of your motors are spinning. Sometimes it's pretty handy to troubleshoot one of your motors or to troubleshoot ESC, so there we go. Some of these debug modes, they have nice names and you can sort of guess what kind of information they gonna give you, for example, current sensor, right? It's pretty obvious. But some of these debug modes are, you know, not very clear. For example, like cycle time, and then you start guessing, like, what kind of cycle is it? PID loop, gyro loop? You don't know. But anyway, for most cases, you don't need all that. So after you set up all of these three settings, don't forget to click save and reboot. After that, scroll a little bit down and make sure we got some free space on the Blackbox chip, so click Erase Flash. And that's how you just clear it from the previous Blackbox recordings. Now, if your quad is ready to fly, well then, you're ready to fly. And this is also very important, what kind of things you need to do in the air for Blackbox recordings. First of all, you need to make sure you don't crash into something. And also make sure that you don't do a bunch of like arming and disarming, because the guy who will watch this Blackbox recording after you send it to him, he'll looking at all these like little Blackbox recordings and will be like, what I'm looking at, like which flight I need to look at. So make sure it is a one nice flight. The next one is what kind of moves and maneuvers in the air you need to do for the Blackbox. Well, first of all, if you have a certain problem, for example, like a weird quad twitching or something like that on the sharp maneuvers, then you have to record Blackbox, which includes this weird twitching. So you need to try to cause this twitching so that it goes into Blackbox. So first of all, the problem you're trying to work on needs to be recorded. Another example, if you have, for example, a bounce back on your drone when you do sharp rolls, then you need to do sharp rolls for the Blackbox recordings and show this bounce back. And it doesn't have to be very difficult in some cases. For example, if you have a weird oscillation noise when you hover, like then you just hover for your Blackbox recordings, that's it. Another example, if you have hot motors and you want to troubleshoot that. In this case, you need to at least perform a flight that caused these motors to be at least a little bit hot. If your drone doesn't have major problems and you just want to fine-tune the filters or PID values, then you need to do a little bit more complicated flight. First of all, make sure you do a couple of full throttle punches, like a very quick one and some slow ones. Then just fly forward, back and forth with the different throttle levels, and then you can try to do different flips and rolls. When you do flips and rolls for Blackbox purposes, make sure you do it separate for roll and separate for pitch. Don't try to do like coordinated turns unless you have a specific problem with the coordinated turns. And also a very important thing, don't, when you do a sharp roll, don't throw your stick like this. Like this is bad, like this is bad. If Mr. Zuck sees this in your Blackbox, he will be very angry. So a good exercise would be rolls like this. You see, I'm not dropping my stick like this, no. It's like this. Then you can also do like a half rolls, like half stick deflection, both ways, and then you do the same for pitch, like full pitch back, then half pitch forward, half pitch back, and then you do the same for yaw. And also you can try to do these moves with different throttle levels. That would be like awesome. Another good exercise to stress your quad and PID tuning is to move your roll stick to one side and then immediately to the other side and then bring it back to zero. Something like this. One, two. One, two. Like, it's kind of not very comfortable to do it this way, but you got the idea. Now you're back on the ground and the final step is to download your Blackbox recording. Connect with Betaflight Configurator, open Blackbox tab, scroll a little bit down and you can see there is a button, Save Flash to File. And it says unsupported. I use this button all the time, it doesn't give me any problems, but you can see sometimes it can give you a problems, and also it is actually slower than if you click right here, activate mass storage device. And if you click that button, then Betaflight start acting like well, external device, and you can copy all your flights from here. I think that's pretty handy too. And you can see here I'm a bad guy because I have multiple flights recorded, and if I were to record a specific problem, now I ended up in the situation where like I don't remember which flight corresponds to the flight that I want to share or look at. And there is, you see there is underscore all Blackbox file, and this underscore all consists of all these flights, but then you still have the same problem. First of all, this is a really big file, and the second, if you share this file with someone else, he will have to figure out which flight you wanted to share, and this is just not comfortable. So the best way, if you have one flight, disarm, download, and then share, review, that's how it works. So now you have your Blackbox file copied. What do you want to do next? Of course, you can try to analyze it by yourself using Blackbox Log Viewer from Betaflight, or you can even use a very fancy and very nice tool from Mr. Brian, PIDToolbox. I will leave a link to all of these tools in the comments. But let's say you are not very experienced, then what are your options? So the first option you have is to share your Blackbox in Betaflight Blackbox Log Review Facebook page. It's a, you know, pretty popular page. You can see 4K members and the people sharing their Blackboxes here and asking for help. And the main tip for you here, please describe in details what kind of problems you have or what you want people to look at, because just your Blackbox and like, hey, what's wrong? Like, you know, it can also work, but normally a good question is a half of the answer. And of course, don't forget to attach your actual Blackbox file. This is important. And the second option you have is a Betaflight Discord server, Blackbox Tuning Help channel. And you can see in this channel, people are sharing Blackbox files and like they're sharing some pictures, discussing like real nerds and, you know, trying to help each other. Some of these people are really experienced, so yeah, try that out too. Right now you cannot share files here more than 8 megabytes, so if your Blackbox recording is bigger than that, please don't hesitate to use, I don't know, Dropbox or Google Drive. That's also an option. I want to repeat it one more time here, that the good question is a half of the answer. So if you share your Blackbox here, please describe what problem you have, describe what did you try already to solve this problem, if you tried default tuning. Yeah, just try to give as much information as possible in one message. And remember, tuning your quad with Blackbox or without Blackbox is not going to make you a better pilot, and all you need to do is...
You must practice. That is it. You must practice. Go outside, fly, burn packs, go tighter, harder, more throttle, tighter lines.
See you in the next video, if I'm not lazy.
Yeah, make all the demons quiet. Yeah, we were built to thrive. Yeah.